Welcome back to my class. You know that I'm Halima Nisan, teacher and junior lecturer of Ahmed High School and Junior College. So here in today's class, we'll discuss about the chapter 21 that is related to the social studies, purpose 2. And here the chapter name is The Movement for the Formation of Telangana State. So here in this lesson, first we will see the merger of a Hyderabad state with the India here. During the last phase of the Indian freedom movement, here the Hyderabad state or the Nizam's domain come into the focus of attention here. Here the Nizam's was contemplating the formation of an independent state under his rule when the British left the India here. So here the nationalist of the Hyderabad state was against this. Here the 8 districts out of the 16 districts of Hyderabad state consist of the Telugu speaking people here, and these parts come to be the called as Telangana. So here the nationalist from the Hyderabad state spread into the village and began a campaign for the formation of education in Telugu language and democratic form of government and the social equality in the 19th, 20s and 30s here. So here the Andhra Mahasabha emerged to promote this cause, and the nationalist from the coastal Andhra was also supported in this movement in the 1940s here. So the movement also took up the issues relating to the land reforms and opposed the role of the Doras, who had the support of the Nizams and the Razakars here. So after this, now we will see about the gentlemen's agreement and the formation of the state of Andhra Pradesh here. So there were the 3 districts regions which spoke the Telugu language, and this included the Telangana, coastal Andhra and Rayalaseema. Besides this, different delegates and the 3 regions also had the different cultures and identities. Exactly. So here the Telangana language was drawn from an inclusive folk of the tradition, which include the tribal languages and the Dakini Urdu and the Kannada and the Marathi also. While these languages of the coastal Andhra was more influenced by the Sanskritized usage. So here the culture of the Telangana was composite of one and was drawn from the Muslims, Dalits and the Aristotle and the tribals and the migrant communities also. So here the social profile of the Telangana was the distinct in that it had a larger portion of the tribal peoples and the backward castes and the Muslims as compared to the other regions. So here the historically the coastal regions had a great influence of the Sanskrit culture than the Telangana. So here they were also under the direct rule of the British and had the access to the English education from the starting of the 19th century. So here the coastal region and undergone a rapid modernization process, and here the Telangana under the Nizams push Urdu as the medium of the instruction, and here the same process was the slow in the promoting the modern education. So here in 1948 Telangana literacy rate was only 9% and especially women literacy was only 4%. And here the proposal to set up a regional council for the Telangana was a major innovation, and the development plans for other regions was supposed to be the drawn up by the state government. So in case of the Telangana, there was to done by the regional councils, and here the regional councils were the secured that all round development of the Telangana. So it was look into all the issues relating to the planning and the development and the irrigation and the industrial development within the general plan. So it would also look into the requirement of the services in the Telangana region, and it was also to control the sale of land in Telangana to the people from outside the region. So here the agreement sought to ensure the equitable expenditure of state resources and also ensuring the educational and the employment opportunities for the youth of Telangana. So here the agreement recognized the distinct identity of Telangana within the new state of Andhra Pradesh, and it come to known as the state within a state. Get it? So here after this, now we will see about the growing discontent in Telangana. Here the despite of the gentleman's agreement, many key points like the constitution of the regional councils were not implemented. Only the regional committee was set up and its recommendations were not mandatory and often ignored by the government here. So here during the period of the plan development from 1956 to 1990, here the many developmental activities took place in the state of Andhra Andhra Pradesh. So here the major dams were built, irrigation and the power projects initiated was vast mining and the industrial complexes were opened here. So the green revolution in agriculture was initiated to transform the agriculture production. Here a large number of the universities and the technical institutions were established. So here after 1990, here the state was a boom in the information technology industry and especially in Hyderabad. So here the people of the Telangana felt that the development was very uneven. So its real benefit were going to the other region of the state. So they also felt that the resources of the Telangana region were not being used for the benefit of the local people here. So the youth also felt that the most of the new employment opportunities created in the state were being concerned by the people of the other region here. Okay, after that, now we will see the Telangana Rashtriya Samiti here. The many organizational experiments like the Telangana Jana Parishad and Telangana Mahasabha and Telangana Jan Sabha and Telangana Akhya Vedika were tried out with the political enthusiasm and the spirit to activism, but no political party emerged. So it was this content that the Telangana Rashtriya Samiti was formed in April 2001, and here the Telangana movement was getting expressed in the different protest forms like Dhoomdham and Garjanas, Padyatras and the traditional Bonalu and drawing the Rangoli, and it was the invoked to the express the popular Telangana demand. So here the Telangana services caste expressed the Telangana movements in protest shaving and the protest washing clothes of their customers on streets and in collective cooking of the Vantavarpu in public places. So this massive spontaneous people's movement was going on in the villages between the December 2009 to April 2010 here. And students spearheaded this movement, and at this juncture students form a joint action committee, that is JAC, and then the feelings of JAC spread to all the organizations and spinning of hundreds of JAC in Telangana. Hundreds of youngsters committed suicide also, and the shattering their families, and the Telangana is a sad saga now. Here the all castes like Chakalis means the washermen, and Nai Brahmins, that is barbers, and Todi Tappers, and Takitapalu, and Dambadas, and Yurakkalas, and Madigas has formed their own jats and joined the protest movement here. Now we will see about the K. Chandrasekhar Rao's past in 2009. So here to give a decisive expression to this momentum, here the K. Chandrasekhar Rao, the leader of the Telangana Rashtriya Samiti, here announced as the indefinite fast to begin on 29th November in 2009 at Siddipet. So he was arrested and the locked in a jail even before he started his fast. So he started the fast in the Khammam jail and subsequently continued it in hospital too. So here the students of the Osmania University formed a Telangana student joint action committee on 16th November to express the solidarity with him. So here the spirit of the people forming the joint action committee, JACS, has spread to the Kakatiya University and then to the Palamur and then to the Satavanha and then to the Mahatma Gandhi Universities of Telangana. Then the employer JACS and the lawyer JACS and the JACS of caste or communities and the district level JACS also sprang up here. So the Telangana Rashtriya Samiti leader, the K. Chandrasekhar Rao, fast became a massive people's movement. So he was fasting for about 10 days between the 29 November and 9 December 2009 here. And here this cleanses was the people in the movement received a new trust and mean. After the fast movement, now we will see the withdrawal of the announcement here. The announcement was a withdrawal on the 23rd December 2009 due to the pressure from the Andhra political leaders and the commissions headed by the Justice Sri Krishna. I was formed to inquire into the developments in Andhra Pradesh and report to the center here. So the Telangana people were shocked here. And here the Hyderabad became the hub of the development, and the city had become India's calling the card for the both success of the economic reform and as well as its claim to the global significance here. So all the resources had been pushed here and has created the imbalanced regional development here. Many people from the different parts had invested in properties in Hyderabad, and had a large number of them had migrated to the Hyderabad in search of employment and education. So here, after this, now we will see that Telangana is achieved here. Here the central government in this background continued its efforts in the consultations with the Congress leader of both the regions, and there was a lot of pressure to take the decision at a national level. Here the Telangana became a national issue, and the Congress core committee heard the presentations from the Andhra side and the Telangana side. So here finally took a decision in favor of the defecation, and according to the bill was passed on the 18th February in Lok Sabha on 20th February in Rajya Sabha, and the president signed on 1st March of 2014. And here the parliament bifurcating the state of Andhra Pradesh with the June 2nd, 2014 and as appointed day. So here in the parliament the bill was supported by the BJP and the BSP and the CPI and other opposition parties also. Here in the democratic process decision may be take on the, but here the persistence of the people's fight in the protest from the convince the country that demerge the Telangana from the Andhra Pradesh. And here the people started the Telangana as the different places, and the students and the other activists felt happy and their dream had been fulfilled. Exactly. So see this Telangana map, that is the Telangana formed on 22nd June in 2014. So by this we have completed our 21st chapter, that is the movement of formation of the Telangana state. So thank you. And by this lesson we have completed our syllabus also.